So that's a problem. You can see the level is way down. Where is it supposed to be, Beth?
It's right up here.
Right up in the middle it's supposed to be. That's the camper. We're in
Slidell, Louisiana.
It's November of
22.
Yep. We just got here yesterday. We limped in from Perry, Florida. We just left on our trip to San Diego.
Mm-hmm. We're on our annual Christmas pilgrimage from Orlando to San Diego. We go and spend a month there with the kids.
So we're going down. We're going down the road. Got a late start. We're on the road Friday night on a four-laner, two lanes in each direction, Highway 27 in Florida.
Uh-huh.
And all of a sudden, the truck flashes out two yellow check engine lights, and then the red one comes on flashing. Never saw that happen before. I'm like, this ain't good. So we were able to find a spot to kind of pull off of the road as the truck stopped running. So now we're on the side of the road in the dark.
And the engine's dead. And the lights are flashing.
And long story short, we weren't quite at our first night stop when this happened.
Yep.
So then what we did is we added some water to that tank that I just showed you. And we made our way to Perry. The next morning, we checked. There were no leaks. I couldn't find a leak. I opened up the crankcase underneath the oil drain and had water come out. So I'm like, okay, we got a problem here. But where are we going to get it fixed? Well, where we're going to get it fixed is here. Well, not especially practically here, but this is Slidell, Louisiana, the Elks Club. We like staying here. You've probably seen videos here before of it. But this is where we're staying for a couple days before we can get the truck into, I think it's Empire Truck Service right here in Slidell. It already called, made arrangements. They're going to, it's first come, first serve. We're going to be there tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock.
6 a.m.
And we're going to see what they say. So we limped here from here. 2 days, 300 miles.
Yeah.
300 miles of stopping every 100 miles and adding another gallon of antifreeze to the truck.
And checking the oil.
The oil's been pretty steady. It hasn't been rising too much. There was no water in it. I'm hoping there's a problem with just an oil cooler or maybe a head gasket that's possibly blown. I hope not.
Yeah, we don't know.
So anyway, we're going to be in Louisiana for a couple days. We figured our drop-dead date of leaving here is 6 days from now.
Yep. And then we'll still make it to...
Or not 6 days from now.
Yeah.
No, it's like 2 weeks from now.
Oh, okay.
6 travel days from here to San Diego.
Yeah, which we've never done. Usually it takes us a month and a half to get
at
there.
At least.
6 days will be fun. Or interesting, anyway. Yep. So, but we can do it.
Yeah.
We can do it.
And we will.
Yeah. Because we have to get there in time for Melanie's birthday.
Yeah. And so this is the deal. The big red monster. And... hopefully we'll get it fixed. Well, that's where we are this morning. It's about 6:30. Got here just before they open. Empire Truck Sales. This is in Slidell. Must be doing good. They're adding on some truck lanes. Talked to a real nice guy here. His name is Tony. He's going to take a look at the truck and see what's happening. Asked them to change the serpentine belt and check those rear tires for us and see if those are going to make it to San Diego. But yeah, these guys got a lot of trucks here, a lot of trucks for sale. Service department opens at 6 and hopefully, fingers crossed, it's not going to be a major thing. Tony said usually with a head gasket, you don't get as much vapor that we had coming out of the exhaust this morning. So that's it. We're here in Slidell on a little hold on our way to San Diego, and hopefully we get this thing going. We're back in Slidell. Actually, we never left Slidell, but we're back at the Slidell Elks. You saw the video, part of the video, where we put the truck over at Empire Truck, had them take a look at it, and we got bad news.
Yeah.
The bad news is the head gasket is blown, which means they have to take the whole top end of the motor off and replace the head gasket. They can't get us in to work on it for 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
2 weeks. Before they can start work on it, the people there were very nice. It wasn't like they didn't want to do the work. They even recommended that we could probably drive farther with the blown head gasket to somebody else who could get in quicker. But we wanted to get the work done here because it's a nice place to hang out.
Well, and the place had really good reviews. Mm-hmm. And a couple people here at the Elks Club said that they've only heard good stories about that place. So, you know, with the way you get trucks fixed, you never know what you're dealing with or whether they're reliable or not. So this place was reliable, so it was important to us to have that.
And back to the timeline thing again, mm-hmm. It's 2 weeks to get in, and then it's going to take them a week to fix it. They have a mechanic there who's basically, his job is Cummings Motors. That's what he does. And I kind of jokingly said, well, I'll get it started here. I'll just start taking the head apart and everything and leave you with a bucket of bolts. He goes, that's not a problem. You could just drop off a bucket of bolts. I know where every bolt goes on that motor. So, and if you think about it, it's really, you know, if that's what you do for a living.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to take him a week to get it done after they have time to get us in there.
Right.
And meanwhile,
The good news is, if it's under warranty, so yeah. We're not going to have to pay for this out of pocket. Our warranty is
like that much.
Our warranty is what,
100,000 miles
or
60 months,
and we're at 81,000 miles on the truck and 58 months. So by next January, we'd be out of warranty. If this happened on our way home from San Diego instead of on the way there, we'd be paying out of pocket. So having a blown head gasket is not a good, you know, it's not good.
It's really low mileage for a diesel to have a blown head gasket. We're going to have to find out if they can figure out why it happened.
Yeah, because we don't want it to happen again.
Right.
So that's the good news. It's under warranty.
And the other good news?
We're in Slidell.
We're in Slidell. We drove from Perry. We stopped in
Meyer State Park
in
Mobile.
We met some friends while we were there from high school, which was kind of weird. They live on the road. We always seem to cross paths, but we met them.
Mm-hmm.
And we added a gallon of antifreeze to the truck every 100 miles or so to get to Slidell because we knew they had the Freightliner dealer here. We called in advance. That's how we got over there at 6 a.m. You know that whole part of the story.
Yep.
So, but that's kind of the sum up here.
Mm-hmm. So now we're just waiting for the call to say, okay, it's time for you guys to bring it in so you can get it fixed. So we'll see when that happens.
And we'll call them.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget.
Make sure that they're on schedule.
Mm-hmm.
Or that we can adjust to whatever their schedule is. Because you really don't, they had a bunch of trucks there. I would say over 100 trucks in there for service. And there were local companies, there were the fire department, there was the electric company, all that. Those guys are big money. We're one RV that they'll probably never see again.
Mm-hmm.
And so...
So you're thinking they're not going to take us in the right order?
They'll take us in whatever order they need to take us in. Mm-hmm. They told us that's when we're going to be there. I'm sure that's what's going to happen.
Okay.
But if we were the fire department, we might have been in there yesterday.
Okay.
You know, but this is what it is, and in my opinion, that's where it's going to be.
Okay.